Namaskar, my dear friends. Welcome to the lecture series of machine design. In our previous video, you will learn about the design of center crankshaft at top dead center position and design of center crankshaft at angle of maximum torque. Now, in this video, you are going to learn about the design of side crankshaft at top dead center. Now, you can see in this figure, the force acting on the side crankshaft is shown here in this figure, okay? So before that, let us understand some assumptions made for this design. So the engine is vertical and the crank is at the top dead center position. That means here it is assumed that engine is vertical. Okay, like engine vertical chhe, and crank chhe, it top dead center position par chhe. And the belt drive is horizontal and the crankshaft is simply supported on bearing 1 and 2. Okay, now here you can see this is the side crankshaft. Here it is the bearing 1 and this is the bearing 2. Okay, એટલે કે આ bearing 1 અને bearing 2 બંને વચ્ચે crank છે એ simply supported છે. બરાબર? તો now you can see here different forces acting on the bearing. Okay, so you can see this PB, PP, okay, load W is vertical load, horizontal load P1 plus P2, and here you can see the different reactions, okay, at bearing 1 and bearing 2. Okay, so the distance between bearing 1 and 2 is C, right? And the distance between the bearing 1 and this load W is C1, and bearing 2 and load is C2. Okay, so here you can see diameter of this shaft is DC and this length is LC, and diameter of this shaft is DS. Okay, now let us see the different bearing reactions. Okay, so the reactions at bearing 1 and 2 due to the force on the crank pin PP are denoted by R1V and R2V. Okay, so here you can see the bearing reaction R1V, okay, and R2V. Okay, due to the here force of pin is PP, so reaction is R1V and here it is R2V. Okay, the reactions at the bearing 1 and 2 due to the weight of flywheel W and sum of belt tension P1 plus P2 are denoted by R1 dash and R2 dash, okay, which is followed by the suffix letter V and H, such as R1 dash V or R1 dash H. Okay, so V is used for the vertical component and H is used for the horizontal component. So you can see here the R1 dash V, okay, and R1 dash H, and here it is R2 dash H horizontal and R2 dash V. Okay, so reaction due to this W and P. Now the you can see the PP is the force acting on the crank pin, D capital D is the diameter of piston, P maximum is the maximum gas pressure inside the cylinder in Newton per mm square or mega Pascal, W is weight of flywheel cum belt pulley. P1 is tension in tight side of the belt and P2 is tension in slack side of the belt. B is overhang distance of force PP from bearing 1. Okay, this distance, it is known as the overhang. Okay, the distance beyond this bearing. So is B. And C is the center distance between bearing 1 and 2. Okay, bearing 1 and 2 distance is C. Now let us see. So at the top dead center position, okay, the thrust in the connecting rod will be equal to the force acting on the piston. Barabar chhe ke top dead center position ma connecting rod upar je thrust lage chhe, e piston upar je force lage chhe na jetlo j hase. Barabar chhe. To a value je chhe, okay, to a force ni value apanne malse force is equal to area into maximum pressure. So area pi by 4 d square. Okay, d itle bore diameter of cylinder to the piston outside diameter to piston no cross section area. And then upper p maximum apne jo itle maximum force. To a je force che piston upar lagto. Okay, pp. Now taking moment of force is about the bearing 2. Barabar chhe. Bearing 2 upar aa tame joi shako chho ke bearing 2 upar apne je force lage chhe eni apne moment laiye to r1v a vertical reaction chhe. Okay, ane r2v. Okay, to bearing 2 about apne laiye ane aa p force chhe aa tame joi shako chho pp. To PP into distance V plus C. Okay, and our moment is a anti-clockwise moment. Okay, so PP into V plus C is equal to R1V. A clockwise moment is R1V into C. So therefore R1V here, R1V, so R1V is equal to PP into V plus C upon C, equation A. Okay, now similarly by taking moment of forces about the bearing 1, so bearing 1 upar lagta forces apne lai shakye to PP into B, okay, distance into R2V, R2V into C. So therefore R2V is equal to PP into B by C, equation B. Okay, now consider the reaction at bearing due to the weight W. Okay, weight W na karane lagthu. Okay, so R1 dash V and R2 dash V. Okay, weight W. So W into C1, okay, taking moment of forces W into C1 is equal to R2 dash V into C. So therefore here this R2 dash, okay, R2 dash V is equal to W into C1 upon C, equation number C. Similarly W into C2, okay, you can see W into this distance is C2, okay, taking moment about W into C2, okay, is equal to R1 dash V into C. So therefore R1 dash V is equal to W into C2 by C, okay, equation D. Now consider the reactions at bearing due to the belt pulley P1 plus P2. Okay, the horizontal reaction have apne consider karshu. To P1 plus P2, so R1 dash H and R2 dash H. Okay, so first of all P1 plus P2 into C1, okay, is equal to R2 dash H into C1 plus C2. Okay, P1 plus P2 into C1, R2 dash H into C. Okay, C1 plus C2 is equal to C. So R2 dash H is equal to P1 plus P2 into C1 by C, equation E. Similarly, P1 plus P2 into C2 is equal to R1 dash H into C. Okay, so R1 dash H is equal to P1 plus P2 into C2 by C. So from this way, you can find all the reactions. Okay, R2 dash V, R1 dash V, R2 dash H, R1 dash H, similarly, R1 V, okay, R2 V. Now, design of crank pin. So let us consider crank. DC is the diameter of crank pin. Okay, LC is the length of crank pin. Sigma B is the allowable bending stress for the crank pin. And PB is the allowable bearing pressure at the crank pin goes. So as discussed earlier, okay, so PB is equal to PP. Okay, bearing pressure PB is equal to load into area. Okay, so PP is the load force on pin, and DC into LC, DC is the diameter and LC is the length. So bearing area DC into LC. Okay, so this L by D ratio for crank pin is usually taken as 0.60 to 1.4. So therefore we can say L by D, LC by DC is equal to 0.60 to 1.4. Okay, and the allowable bearing pressure at the crank pin is generally assumed from 10 to 12 megapascal if not given. So take the value of PB is equal to 10 to 12 Newton per mm square. Now, the crank pin which act as a cantilever, okay, and subjected to the bending stress. Okay, you can see the crank is acting as a cantilever beam, right? So therefore, okay, so if it is assumed that load PP is uniformly distributed on the length of the crank pin and the maximum bending moment, okay, is given by MB is equal to PP into LC by 2. Okay, PP into LC by 2. Okay, so if we assume that the load is not uniformly distributed and the located at the end of the crank pin, barabar chhe, load chhe UDL nathi, uniformly distributed nathi, ane crank pin na chheda upar lagto hoy, to apne ane maximum bending moment is MB into is equal to PP into LC. બરાબર છે તો આ બંને ઇક્વેશન છે આપણે એના ઉપરથી એવું કહી શકીએ કે લિમિટિંગ વેલ્યુઝ ઇન ટુ કન્ડિશન ઓકે વી વિલ એઝ્યુમ ધ મીન વેલ્યુ બરાબર છે બંનેનું મીન વેલ્યુ આપણે લઈએ તો ઇટ ઇઝ MB is equal to 3 by 4 PP into LC બરાબર ઇક્વેશન A અને B ઉપરથી બંનેનું આપણે મીન વેલ્યુ કન્સિડર કરીએ તો MB is equal to 3 by 4 PP into LC. Now, we assume that the load, this PP, it act at a distance of 0.75 LC. બરાબર છે? It is acting at 0.75 LC. Here you can see. Okay? So, therefore, the section modulus for the crank pin, okay, is given by pi by 32 dc cube. Okay, pi by 32 dc cube. So MB is equal to sigma b into z section modulus. So sigma b pi by 32 dc cube section modulus. Okay, so the bending stress in the crank pin are calculated by using above equation. Okay, and this should be within the permissible limit. બરાબર છે આના ઉપરથી બેન્ડિંગ સ્ટ્રેસ મળે અને એ બેન્ડિંગ સ્ટ્રેસ છે એ પરમિસિબલ લિમિટમાં હોવું જોઈએ. હવે ડિઝાઇન ઓફ બેરિંગ. નાઉ ડી વન ઇઝ ધ ડાયામીટર ઓફ જર્નલ ઓર શાફ્ટ એટ બેરિંગ વન, એલ વન ઇઝ લેન્થ ઓફ બેરિંગ વન, ઓકે સિગ્મા બી ઇઝ ધ એલાઉબલ બેન્ડિંગ સ્ટ્રેસ ફોર શાફ્ટ એટ બેરિંગ ન્યુટન પર એમએમ સ્ક્વેર, ટી ઇઝ ધ થિકનેસ ઓફ વેબ. So the thickness of wave, which is calculated by empirical relation, and that relation is equal to T is equal to 0.45 dc to 0.75 dc, right? And bending moment at the bearing 1 is given by bending moment at bearing 1 is equal to mb is equal to pp into that distance 0.75 lc plus thickness of the wave plus 0.5 l1, you know that the length of the bearing one, so half of that, so therefore pp is equal to 0.75 lc plus t plus 0.5 l1. okay, so length of bearing is calculated by this equation, so it's given by l1 is equal to 1.5 dc to 2 dc. L1 ની વેલ્યુ આપણે આમાં 1.5 DC to 2 DC જેટલી વેલ્યુ આપણે લઈ શકીએ. Okay. Now, bending stress in the shaft. Okay, so the bending stress in the shaft of the bearing 1 is equal to MB is equal to sigma B pi by 32 D1 square. Okay, pi by 32 D1 square is a, it's a section modulus. Okay, Z, this value is what? Section modulus Z. Okay. Right. So the dimensions D1 and L1, okay, are to be checked for the bearing pressure. D1 and L1 જે છે એને આપણે bearing pressure ઉપર check કરશું. તો આ equation ઉપરથી આપણને D1 ની value મળી જશે. Okay. અને આ equation ઉપરથી આપણે D1 છે diameter એ આપણે find કરી શકશું. હવે આપણે D1 અને L1 ને આપણે બેરિંગ પ્રેશરમાં ચેક કરશું. સો બેરિંગ પ્રેશર PV ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ R1 અપોન D1 બાય L1. ઓકે, સો ધ એલાઉબલ બેરિંગ પ્રેશર, ઓકે એલાઉબલ બેરિંગ પ્રેશર ઇઝ 10 ટુ 12 MPa. સો PV ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 10 ટુ 12 MPa. રાઈટ. અને રિએક્શન R1 ઇઝ ગિવન બાય, યુ કેન સી રૂટ R1 V plus R1 dash V whole square plus R1 dash H square. એટલે કે બેરિંગ વર ઉપરનું ટોટલ જે રિએક્શન છે, ઓકે ધીસ રિએક્શન ઇઝ ગિવન બાય ધીસ ઇક્વેશન R1 ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ R1 V પ્લસ R1 dash V square પ્લસ R1 dash H square. ઓકે, તો ધ બેરિંગ 1 એન્ડ 2 બોથ આર મેડ આઇડેન્ટિકલ. સિમિલરલી યુ કેન ફાઇન્ડ ધ reactions at bearing 2. Now, design of crank wave. Okay, crank wave ની design. તો crank wave છે, it is subjected to the eccentric load PP. Okay, crank wave છે, આપણે figure ઉપર જોઈએ તો આ વેવ ઉપર eccentric load કેવો લાગે છે? PP જેટલો load લાગે છે, બરાબર. આની width છે W અને થિકનેસ છે T. ઓકે, સો ડાયરેક્ટ કમ્પ્રેસિવ સ્ટ્રેસ, એસેન્ટ્રિક લોડ છે તો બે ટાઈપના સ્ટ્રેસ લાગે છે, સેન્ટ્રલ પ્લેન, ઓકે ડાયરેક્ટ કમ્પ્રેસિવ સ્ટ્રેસ અને બેન્ડિંગ સ્ટ્રેસ ડ્યુ ટુ ધ લોડ PP. સો ડાયરેક્ટ જે સ્ટ્રેસ લાગે છે, ધ ડાયરેક્ટ સ્ટ્રેસ, ઓકે ઇઝ ગિવન બાય સિગ્મા C ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ PP into area, area is equal to W into T, width and thickness, right? This is the direct stress. And the bending moment, so bending moment is equal to load PP into distance 0.75 LC plus T by 2. And section modulus for the rectangular section, that is the WT square by 6. So sigma B is equal to MB by J. બરાબર છે, સિગ્મા બી ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ એમબી બાય છે. તો ટોટલ કમ્પ્રેસિવ સ્ટ્રેસ ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ સિગ્મા સી પ્લસ સિગ્મા બી. ઓકે, તો આ જે ટોટલ કમ્પ્રેસિવ સ્ટ્રેસ છે, ઇટ શુડ બી અ less than the allowable bending stress. Okay. Now, last, design of shaft under flywheel. Okay. So, the forces acting on the shaft under the flywheel are as we saw in figure. Okay. So, central plane of the shaft is subjected to the maximum bending moment. Barabar chhe? So, ds, okay, as per this figure. Okay, so different reactions are there. And ds is the diameter of this shaft. Okay, so the max, by taking the maximum bending moment, so MBV is equal to PP into B plus C1 minus the R1V plus R1 dash V into C1. Okay. So the bending moment in horizontal plane is MBH. Okay. This is the bending moment in vertical plane. Here in horizontal plane, it is MBH is equal to R1 dash H into C1. Barabar. So resultant bending moment MB is equal to MBV square plus MBH square. Barabar, a resultant bending moment. Away our bending moment is equal to section modulus into bending stress. So pi by 32 ds cube into sigma b. Okay, so shaft no diameter upon a I equation upper t ds ni value. Okay. So now I hope you can understand very well about the design of side crankshaft at top dead center position. Okay. So in our next lecture, we will learn about the design of side crankshaft at angle of maximum torque. Okay. So thank you. Thank you very much.